This is an RX 5700 XT. Now, this particular RX 5700 XT, I bought on eBay a couple months ago for $48. Now, you might be thinking that's almost too good to be true, and it kind of is, because the seller said that he sat this in a box for about a year, and when he tried to power it up recently, he couldn't get it to display video, turn on, or really do anything. So I thought, you know, maybe if this seller is being truthful, maybe it's worth the risk. So I ended up buying it for this price, paid just under $50 for it, got the card, and this is the results. I thought maybe I could pick something simple to try and do to try and fix the card, but it ended up being a little more complicated than I thought. But the reason I chose this card is because the RX 5700 XT is still a really good card, especially at 1080p, because you can still game at max settings 1080p, and it is about as similar to an RTX 2070, if not a little better at times. I'll show benchmarks on screen, but it's a pretty good card, and you can find a working one for about $150 used on eBay, which is a really good price, especially if you're looking for a budget gaming card and you only want to do 1080p or so. But anyways, more about this particular card that I bought. I bought it on eBay, it came in about a week, and this is the result. So, opening up the graphics card, it came in an anti-static bag, which is pretty normal, and it looks like it's in pretty good physical condition, which is kind of confusing to me. But if we look at the back of the graphics card, we can see that there's supposed to be a little white sticker over one of the screws on the back that says void warranty, and that sticker has already been tampered with, meaning that somebody else has already tried to repair this. Now, this is not a great sign for me, because if somebody else has already tried to repair it and they were unsuccessful, the likelihood of me being able to fix it is not great. Either way, I decided to go ahead and try this in a test bench system, and I plugged it in, got it ready to go, turned on the power, and nothing. Thankfully, it was just that I had forgot to plug the graphics card into the power connectors. So, plugged it back in, plugged all the power connectors in, tried it again, and to my absolute surprise, the graphics card turned on and displayed. Now, I tried it with HDMI because this is what I had to hook up to a spare TV to test, but I don't know if the display ports were working, I don't know what was really wrong with this, but immediately I could see that it has some major artifacting. Now, beyond the artifacting, when I eventually was able to get into Windows to get into the control panel, I saw that the graphics card itself didn't exactly register within Task Manager. But Windows did still detect the graphics card, at least according to GPU-Z, which recognized that this was an RX 5700 XT. So at least that's kind of a good sign that the system can recognize that there is a graphics card and recognize which graphics card it is. But either way, the fans on the graphics card didn't spin at all. It got a little bit warm, but not overly concerning. I'm not sure if this is a BIOS thing or what. Now, eventually, I did try reflashing the BIOS, which didn't do anything. I tried updating the AMD drivers several times, restarting, and it never actually initialized the drivers. Every time I would restart and try to open the drivers, it would say that there's not a compatible device detected. So it sounds like there's something wrong with the graphics card itself. It's a hardware issue, not a software issue, which is not what I was hoping for at all. But I'm guessing that it's either one of the memory chips or the GPU die itself. So, I decided to use the last resort because I was hoping this would be an easy fix, but it's time to bring out the heat gun. Now, in the past I've used the heat gun on about 3 or 4 graphics cards and it's only ever worked on one, and that was my GTX 760, which I actually did a video about. The heat gun actually managed to fix the artifacting and then it was fully recognized by Windows, and I figured maybe I could give it a try here and maybe, just maybe, it would fix this graphics card and bring it back to life. What you're seeing now is sped up footage of me struggling to take apart this graphics card so that I can get all the heatsink, all the cooler, and anything that might melt off of the graphics card. I want to take absolutely everything off except for the PCB itself. Now, when it comes to using the heat gun, I'm sure there's a lot of methods out there. In fact, there are lots of videos that show you how to do it, but I'm just gonna wing it. So here I am outside with my very makeshift setup, and I have my Harbor Freight heat gun ready to go. This is not an exact science, and I wouldn't super recommend trying this because it doesn't always work, but we're already here, so we might as well try it out. After hitting this graphics card with a heat gun for about 5 minutes or so, I let it sit because it was still very hot, and of course it's very hot outside in the summer, so it took a little while to cool down. But I put everything back together, I put the cooler back on, I didn't apply thermal paste just because I didn't think this was going to work, to be honest. So I put everything else back together, threw it back into my janky testing machine, which, by the way, look at this cooler setup. Anyways, the moment of truth, the moment that you've been waiting for. If you clicked on this video, you wanted to see, can a heat gun fix this $50 graphics card that I just randomly found on eBay? And the answer is no. In fact, it actually made it worse, because now the graphics card isn't detected or posting or really doing anything. We get a B2 error, which comes up as a graphics card error for the motherboard, which means it doesn't know what to do with the graphics card. So, would I recommend trying this at home? No, absolutely not. If you think that you can fix graphics cards by yourself, go for it, but I would suggest learning how to actually do it other than just the simple quick fixes, because there have been times where I've gotten very lucky. If you've seen my 3090 video, I found somebody on eBay who thought that they had a broken graphics card when in fact they did not, and it works just fine, and I'm still using that to this day. But I've also had a couple other opportunities where I've bought broken graphics cards and they stay broken, like this one. But it's always fun to take a gamble on these graphics cards that I find on eBay, and if I find any more, I'll definitely make a video about it, because some of them are actually pretty good deals when you find ones that can just be fixed simply by a BIOS or driver update. But something like this is a little more complicated and something that I don't really have the tools to do. To fix this properly, I probably would have had to reball and resolder either the GPU die or the memory, which I don't think I can confidently do, so this one is just gonna stay like this. It's gonna stay broken. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe and comment what you thought. I know it's kind of underwhelming because we didn't actually fix the graphics card, but hey, I thought it was an interesting video. I thought it might be a cool concept, but you know, this is probably the most realistic outcome we could have had. But yeah, there you go, $48 graphics card from eBay. If it was working, I would say it's a great graphics card, but it's not, so yeah, that's all.